Brighton is home to one of the most beautiful palaces in the world. But when I go there, my favourite part is the kitchen. And I'm delighted to have in the studio today Kyla Booth-Lucking. We've got a Heritage Open Day coming, which has a culinary slant this year.
That's right.
Yes. What's going to happen?
Well, it's on Sunday the 19th of September, 10 till 4, at the Brighton Dome. And this year the theme is Edible England. So we've got a number of different things, including looking at how the food that was served to the Indian soldiers who were recuperating at the Dome. We've got a talk by the Chattery Memorial Group, looking at some of that and reading some of the letters from the Indian soldiers. There'll be other talks and tours, and you can find out about the lashings of plum pudding that they served to the Prince Regent, and how the Studio Theatre, which was also known as the Pavilion Theatre, yes. Was also a supper room, and lots of other little culinary nuggets as part of our Heritage Open Day.
It's fascinating that the Dome became part of a hospital complex for those returning Indian soldiers who came back. But in culinary terms, were they people cooking for them charged with creating Indian food?
Yes, they were. Yes, it was seen as really important that they had food that was normal for them to eat and would aid their recovery. And we've got some old photographs where you can see people using the kitchens with huge tureens full of curry dishes.
Great big curries.
Yeah, we've got some of the recipes that were used. So if people wanted to, they could borrow those recipes and make something at home.
That's really good, because I think sometimes when we talk about heritage, it's all a bit, you can look at it, but you can't touch. And actually getting people involved in a different way, especially with food, is a really big move forward in terms of how we perceive our history.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, some of our original ideas were to have a huge canteen open on the day where everyone would be able to try the food. As you can imagine, COVID's
put pay
to
that.
Yeah, but there would have that was some of the original ideas. So maybe we'll bring those back. And we actually will be looking at the North Lane as well, our neighbouring area, and how that's just such a bustling food area as well, and how the Dome is connected with its local restaurants. And
I know from my experience of being in the complex, there was an enormous kitchen in the basement underneath the corn exchange. Is that still there with the redevelopment?
Well, it's a really good question, because I started working at the Dome, I think, 2 weeks before lockdown. So I haven't had my tour round yet to know if it's still there. I've been into one of the basement areas, but that's been completely modernised and transformed into backstage and under the stage tech areas. But I don't know about the kitchen, so I think I'll have to sneak onto the tour this weekend and see if it's still there, and I'll send you a photo.
It's very interesting how much we can go and see within the complex and how much we can't go and see. I know I was very privileged years ago to be allowed to go up into the Dome above the Royal Pavilion and see those incredible rooms that were used as wards for those Indian soldiers. And there's still graffiti on the walls that those soldiers actually left there. It's incredible. I mean, it's a shame we can't, but I know that as a building, it's so fragile, you're not allowed to do those things. But it is interesting that you're able to involve the public and see them in different virtual ways these days. And that, I think, is that going to become far more part of what you do as an events team?
Yeah, absolutely. I think we have funding from the National Lottery Heritage Fund, and a huge thing that they're encouraging everyone to do is to make heritage as accessible to all kinds of different people as possible. And so, on Sunday, we'll have an exhibition where you can see photographs and artefacts. And we've got, some really lovely and quirky things, and as we've been doing the renovations and the redevelopment, we've discovered all sorts of graffiti in all sorts of places from all kinds of eras, and so we're obviously capturing as much of that as we can with photographs and with video, and we'll be putting that into an online archive that by the time we reopen, it will be available. Even if you can't make it to the building yourself, you'll be able to see it online.
Are you going to relax the rule about taking photographs within the complex? I always find it's very funny that most people these days are thrilled when people use their phones to take a photograph and say, online, on social media, here I am. But when you go into the pavilion itself, there's restrictions on what... I mean, is that a legal requirement?
I don't actually know about the pavilion, because that's obviously a part of the Royal Pavilion estate, and I'm very much on the Brighton Dome side of things. And I know in gigs and stuff, obviously some artists are absolutely fine about those things, and some
It has
aren't.
Changed, hasn't it?
Yes, yes. And especially, particularly if you go and watch any concert, everyone's got their phones out, so it's...
I find that very irritating, actually. If you're stood behind someone, or sat behind someone... I've actually sat behind people with an iPad. And you're thinking... Put that away. What's the point of filming something when you're here to hear it live and see it live?
Yeah. I know that there's some artists where you can arrange to have the phones all locked away so that you're just there in the moment. Actually, I think that is what a lot of our audiences do. We don't have phones as much as I think other places.
It's very exciting to see the complex coming out of lockdown and look at a programme which is burgeoning with new stuff to see. And it's been very hard. I know you've got another exhibition opening with some work from one of the members of the team with paintings.
That's right, yes. The Art of G by one of our staff members, Graham Cameron. It's part of our reopening about really embracing and celebrating the way our team has held together during obviously a really difficult 18 months. Graham had contributed a piece of artwork to every staff newsletter, and it became a real talking point when we had our online get-togethers. Yeah. And so... The exhibition will be featuring a number of those artworks, and then there's an auction at the end to raise some funds, which partly will contribute to the reopening of Brighton Dome.
Excellent. Mm. That sounds really good. So we've got the Heritage Open Day, which is Sunday, 10 till 4.
Yep.
In the Dome complex.
Yep.
And that exhibition of his paintings opens?
That is on the 26th of October till the 31st. That's 11 till 3 each day.
And I've seen some of the paintings. They are really lovely, aren't they?
They're so great. There's loads of Brighton landmarks and images that it just, particularly when everyone was locked at home, was
And the level
so
of humour in them as well, which I liked as well. Listen, I hope people come along on Sunday and maybe they'll just pop up and have a curry afterwards.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, some of the events are bookable, so it's best to check the website first, but there is also drop-in activities, including, I forgot to mention, the letter writing, that children can write a letter to their future selves.
What a lovely idea.
On the day.
Yeah. I always say that history starts today. I think that's an important fact. Thank you so much for coming in and talking about it. And do get along to the Dome complex and have a look at what's going on and the programme for the coming month, which is very exciting. Thank you again.
Thank you.